With you, our first guest is actually online. He's on the telephone, Mr. Anderson Matheson. We all know him as Leftist from Karakou. He's the secretary of the Karakou United Cricket Board, and we're talking this morning about the appointment of Mr. Emmanuel Stewart as captain of the Windward Islands under 17 cricket team for upcoming regional tournament. Mr. Matheson, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Okay, it's good to have you on the phone.
Just
tell us a little bit about yourself, first of all.
Well, the secretary of the Karakou United Cricket Board, the body with the responsibility of organizing cricket here in Karakou since 2001. We've organized both under 15, under 19, and senior tournaments here in Karakou, and organizing the teams in each category. So we have that responsibility. I'm also an umpire, West Indies qualified, and I'm also a coach. So once it comes to cricket, I'm more involved in all aspects of cricket here in Karakou.
Okay, great. So this has been involved in for quite a while.
Well, since my kid, that's my first love as sport.
Okay.
I've been a kid, I've been always involved in sport, playing cricket, played for Karakou, captain the Karakou national senior team.
Mm-hmm.
And it's something I hope to continue till I can't do anymore.
Okay, well, that's good. So let's talk now about the appointment of Emmanuel Stewart as the captain of the Windward Islands under 17 cricket team. That's correct, right?
Yes, he is.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about Mr. Stewart, first of all.
Well, Mr. Stewart is a very gifted and talented cricketer from Karakou. Started playing in the senior competition, you wouldn't believe, at the age of 10. Never before had any persons in Karakou played at the senior level at early age. And I was fortunate enough to be the umpire in the game, the first game he played in against Harveyville. And when I saw him, I told him, guys, this is a cricketer we have to look for. But somebody had previously told me about him, his ability, and when I actually said, I say the person isn't lying, that this young man is someone we have to look for in the future, and he has blossomed really as expected, and we know that he still has work to do to get to the next level, but I think he has the discipline and the temperament to get there.
Right. The picture I just saw on the screen there is that of a young man who looks almost shy. What can you say about his personality itself?
He's a very, very reserved person. I say he's very, when he's among his peers and his friends, he's very jovial, talks a lot, fool around as any teenage boy would do. But when it comes to his cricket and thing, he's very serious. He don't like probably picking as much, but as I told him, I remember when he came from the St. Vincent in 2013 as the MVP of that under 15 tournament, I tell him, I say, get accustomed to this. get accustomed to this, because I mean, with his ability, once you go there and perform, these things are going to be coming, and you can't run from it. So he has taken it in strides, and I mean, when called upon to do what he has to do, he can deliver. But he's not the person you would push to go to the front to do anything. He's very reserved in that aspect. But when called upon to do it, he'll show up.
But despite the fact that he doesn't really push, I mean, people are still seeing his potential, right?
Most definitely.
Okay, good. What about...
Every time he goes out and bat, and you can see this young man has something in him.
Okay. What about family support and support from peers and things like that?
Well, I think he cannot ask for anything more from his family. His father is dead, but his mom and his sisters, he's the only brother, the only boy in the family. So he's well taken care of by the family. I think he has all the support from his sisters and his mom to do everything that he wants to do, and they're behind him 100%. So with that, they ensure that he does his schoolwork, because he's top of his class in school. They ensure that he does his schoolwork, and it's another chance that he can fall away and do what he's supposed to do. You know, so I think the family support is very strong and is very, very evident. And then he goes and play, the family is there supporting him, shouting from the crowd.
What for him right now?
I think he's in Form 4 at the Hillcrest Academy.
Oh, so he has another
form
year to
four,
go.
Form 4, Form 5. I think he's in Form 5.
All right, but for the meantime, he's managing to balance his school life with what he has to do on the field?
Most definitely. He's been doing that since from primary school, and he hasn't stopped. The family has made ensure when it's time for training, he goes to training. When it's time for his studies, he's there. Because I remember yesterday, he was in the... on Wednesday, we were session with another young man who is on the under 15, Kazari Charles from Karakou. We was doing some work with him. He's a fast bowler. And Emmanuel came across from his school, and he said, he's in a lesson, but he had a little break, so he just come across to see what's happening. Because he and Kazari from the same village, very close neighbors. So they work together well, so he just comes to see what is happening to ensure that the young man, and give him little pointers, because he was there, went through the process, so he know what to expect, and he was there with us, but he in school uniform, and then when he had to go back, so he went back. Okay. But he's really into it.
Okay. All right, so he has been appointed captain of the Windward Islands under 17 team. A while ago, you mentioned about St. Vincent of the under 15 team as well?
Yes, he was in 2013, he was captain of the under 15 team, and he came back with the prize for the most runs, most outstanding wicketkeeper, and the player of the tournament.
So are those two his major feats so far, or what else has he done that is notable so far?
Well, he had been on the Windward Islands under 17 team last year also. He was not captain, but they say he has been elevated to the captain. He has traveled to Australia with the Trinidad All-Star under 17 in 2013. They went to Australia and played a series of one-day games, and he was part of that team himself, and I think Darrell Cyrus from Grenada went to the Trinidad under 17 team to Australia. So he has an experience of playing, and I remember telling somebody, imagine my own character walking onto the field of Sydney and playing cricket. You know, so that's the kind of exposure that he has given, his talent has given him. The guys in Trinidad saw him at the West Indies tournament, and they invited him to be part of the team going to Trinidad.
Okay, great. And he's at a very young and impressionable. Is there a fear sometimes that these things might sort of take a toll on him? You know how it could be for some people if they might not be able to handle these situations well?
Yes, that's something we always worry about, but I think with the support of his family, especially his sisters and them, they're always behind him, and I haven't seen a change in his demeanor, in his attitude. He's still very respectable, very disciplined in everything that he do. And I've seen him playing 10 years old, and I cannot tell you I've seen any change in his behavior, in his attitude. He has remained the humble young man that I know he is, and I think with the proper guidance and support from his family, he's going to continue being that person.
How old is he right now? 15, 16?
He's 16.
16. What do you think would have given him, of course you've mentioned a lot of his attributes, but what do you think would have given him the edge over maybe other possible contenders for this role as captain?
His knowledge of the game. He's a student of the game. He goes online, studies lots of cricket, looks at cricket a lot, he reads up about the game, about history of the game. He has that ability to, when he's out on the field, to read the game to a level where I think, I'm telling guys, he's probably one of the best in terms of knowledge of the game in Carrico. He's probably one of the best cricketers with knowledge of the game on the field, can adjust to what the situation tells you, and he's very knowledgeable of the game. So I think that gives him the edge in terms of his ability to be captain, because he reads the game very well. He's also the wicketkeeper, and he's in a position behind the stump, so he can actually see everything that's happening, almost like a view of what the batsman is seeing. So he can always adjust and make the necessary changes that needs to be done.
His knowledge of the game. So let's just say West Indies is playing, whether West Indies is playing, you're here in the West Indies or they're on assignment, whether England, Australia, wherever, and he's looking at some of these players, he can actually spot some of the mistakes and see where they're going wrong, although they would be more experienced than him.
Most definitely. Because a lot of our young players, when they look at cricket on TV, they look at a big shot, a spectacular catch. But the basic thing, the footwork, they don't look at that. How would a batsman move his feet to play a certain shot? How would he keep a move before he dives to take a catch? And these are things he looks at and picks up very, very easy. It just comes natural to him.
But so how does he feel? I mean, I know as West Indians, we always want West Indies to look to win, but we know the situation as it is right now. How does he feel being so knowledgeable about the game, although he's this young? How does he feel, you know, whenever he sees he's on the losing end?
Well, like all West Indians, we feel downhearted when we see West Indies lose, but then they'll come and give us a wonderful performance like they did in the last test match, and they'll raise our hopes high up again, and we're back on a high. It's the same ebb and flow up and down as all West Indians. Wrestling and cricket fans, but he has the ability that he can get onto the team in the near future and probably stem the flow of the losing and start bringing us to the days when we win again.
Oh, that would be very nice.
Yeah, his goal is to play at the Adland. I think, barring any unforeseen circumstances, I think he's going to get there.
Okay, that's good. It would be very nice to be flying Grenada flag at that level again.
When that day happens, I can probably retire and say again, I've seen it all.
Okay, that's good. So have you spoken with him since the appointment? When exactly was the appointment?
The appointment, I think, was made on Monday. I've spoken to him. Like I say, we was in a session on Wednesday with Kazari, and he was there. He came across there, and we were talking, you know, preparing, because the tournament is in July in Tobago. So he's also starting a session, his regular training. soon, but he's doing some internal exams now, so you know, once the exams is there, that takes priority, but as soon as the exam is finished, you're going to try to get back into the full swing of training.
Right, so their first assignment, you're saying, is in July?
In July. Under-17 team. And he's also, and probably I might be jumping again, he might be on the with Grenada on the under-19 team also.
Okay, well, he's doing very well. That is good. His family must be very proud of him.
They are. Like I said, they're behind him 100%. Everything he needs, they're there to support him.
Let me make sure I get this clear. The first assignment, July in Tobago.
Yes.
Is it? All right.
Yeah, I think tournament starts on the 6th of July.
6th of July, thereabout. Okay, great. So, but in speaking to him, is there anything you would have mentioned that he wants to do, you know, as the first order of business in terms of just motivating the team? Because, of course, they're very young people as well.
Yeah, but I think prior to the team leaving, there might be come with me together and have a little camp. I think meeting, but the good thing, like he mentioned, most of the guys on the team, he knew them from under 15. He captained them at under 15 level, so there's some level of familiarity with the players. So you know what their strengths and weaknesses are, most of them. So I think that all goes well for him as captain, because he has captained them before at under 15. I think he have earned their respect as a captain.
Great. So does he feel, because he is, like you said, he's captain before, but does he in any way feel, because this is he's a little older now, this is a little, you could say, maybe a little more serious now at an older age, does he in any way feel a little affected by anything at all, or he's ready for any challenge that he meets?
I think he's ready, because recently he was captain of the Carrico on the 19th team in the Grenada tournament, and the team Carrico made it into the semifinals, and he got the first entry of that tournament. I think he likes the challenge of being leader and going out front and leading by example. He likes that challenge. I think he gives me responsibility as a batsman to go out there and lead from the front by making runs for the team. And once he is doing that, the team is very confident they can do well.
Right. Okay. Yes. So he's confident that they will. But even if they don't, if he doesn't lead them to victory, at least they will do very well in the tournament.
Most definitely.
Okay. Great. All right. So is there anything else you'd like to add before we wrap up, Mr. Matheson? Really good speaking with you.
Well, it's just that yes, he Emmanuel is probably the one that is on the front, but we have another youngster that's coming up. Like I mentioned earlier, young Kazari Charles was on the Grenada under 15 team to the tournament in St. Lucia. He got onto the Grenada Islands team with the other players, and he's now been training, preparing for that tournament also sometime in July. So we're working with him to ensure that when he goes to that level, he can perform to the level that we know he's capable of, and do as well as Emmanuel did when he was there 2 years ago. Like I said, both of them from the same area, they're neighbors, so they have someone he can talk to get what exactly happens in the tournament, how it is, so he can be prepared when he goes out there in the tournament. I think tournament might be, we've seen this tournament might be in Guyana. I think he's in Guyana this year, so he's there. And then we have young Mikael Joseph, and Kijani Simon, and they're on the 19 team. And we have a nice young program of young under 15 and 19 players that we're working with. Still have a lot of work to do, but we're going to continue working them and encourage them to do the work. And once they continue doing the work, we're going to see the success.
Great. So we just have to keep them focused, ensure
most
that they remain focused.
Most definitely.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thanks
it's
for having
a pleasure
me.
Speaking with you. Most welcome.
Okay.
We have been speaking with Mr. Anderson Matheson in Carrico. He's the secretary of the Carrico United Cricket Board. And of course, as he just mentioned to us, we've been talking about Emmanuel Stewart, the appointment of Mr. Emmanuel Stewart as the captain of the Windward Islands under-17 cricket team. And he has had stints before as well, doing very well. Their first assignment is somewhere in early July in Tobago. And of course, he's confident that they will do well. So we do wish him all the very best. We take a quick break. We'll be right back.